All right, so unfortunately, guys, the audio kind of went out on this part, so I'm going to go ahead and do post-commentary as best as I can right now. So, yeah. So basically, right here, I'm selecting my team. I decide to lead with Bulu. No, actually, I'm going with Bulu, Garchomp, Magnezone, Palisand, Smeargle, and Mega Metagross. And I'm against Devin, my man Devin, a member of the Dragon Army. But yeah, unfortunately, this part, I was trying to preview the stream earlier before this, the recording. I was trying to preview the recording earlier before this, and unfortunately, I forgot to turn back on my mic, so rip. Which I've never done that before, so hey, I guess it's the first time for everything. But, so here it is. So basically, I'm going over this. I'm like, huh, what is he going to lead with? I'm thinking about it. I'm like, I wonder. And this is post-commentary, but I'm going to try to keep it as, like, you know, live as I can, where it feels like it's not post. You know what I mean? Like, the way I'm announcing it. Like, I'm not going to be like, oh, and then he goes for this. I'm going to be like, oh, he went for this. So, yeah, just, if it seems like a, you know, not like a usual post-commentary, there's a reason. All right. So here's Devin. He's starting out. He's got that classic style right there. I decided to lead Smeargle because I want to go ahead and I want to set up some hazards all up in his face. He decides to lead with Toxapex. And right here, I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna set up sticky webs. That's what I'm gonna do. So right now, I just go ahead and I set up sticky webs because sticky webs is so key. It slows down your opponent. It does so much work. He goes for poison jab, but I mean, it's Toxapex. He's not the strongest guy in the world, so he, you know, I'm able to live. So I'm like, all right, because I'm able to live, I'm gonna set up some spikes because spikes is gonna benefit me more than stealth rocks, considering that pretty much everything on his team resists stealth rocks or is not superly affected by stealth rocks. He goes for another poison jab and takes out my beautiful Smeargle. So Smeargle goes down, and I decide at this point, okay, I think I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna switch in. I think I decided to switch in Garchomp at this point. So we'll see. I'm pretty sure it's Garchomp. We're about to see, baby. We about to see this right now. But the audio was not off the entire time, so you'll see. Okay, no, that's right. I decided to switch into Babe Magnet because Liquidation isn't going to do much, and also Poison Jab is not effective. So I switch in Babe Magnet and decide to just straight up go for Raw Power and go for a Thunderbolt. That's what I decided to go for. I'm like, I'm going to go for a Thunderbolt right here because it should be able to one-shot. But then I forgot Toxapex can be insanely bulky, ridiculously bulky. So, yeah. He decides to go for the Withdraw and switches in Shukaku. But I predicted that he might go for a switch, so I went for Hidden Power. And I'm glad that I did. I went for Hidden Power Fire to possibly be able to get some kind of switch in here. So I go for Hidden Power Fire. Pa-fire. And it does an okay amount, doesn't do much, and I know that this thing's going to want to fire off an Earth Power, so I don't want to stay in against Shukaku. Not even close. Don't want to stay in against him. It's just going to be a bad time. It's just going to be a bad time. He's just going to try to tap dance all over my face with that 4x effective Earth Power, and I don't want that. I don't want him to do that, man. I don't want him to do that. So I'm like, no, you're not going to do that to me, eh? Not today, eh? You know? I'm getting crazy with all this. But I decide to go ahead and switch out, because I'm not going to stay in. Flash Cannon would be resistant. Thunderbolt would obviously be not effective. And Hidden Power Fire, you already saw, it did barely anything to him. Did not do much. So I decided I need to make the switch. But I don't know why, I guess. I guess it took me longer than I thought, or it just took Devin longer to make his decision of what move he wanted to do. No, yeah, I see now. So it just took me a while to think of my switch. So I decided to switch into Garchomp. Yep, that's what I thought. Oh, So I switch into Darude Sandstorm. He goes for Earth Power. I obviously resist, but still does a solid amount, which makes me think that he's Specs. I don't know for sure. He might have been Specs. Like, we might have been doing dual Specs and not even knowing it. Because I know that I was running Specs, but I don't know if he was running Specs too. So we'll see. I go for the Earthquake, thinking it'll do a decent amount. He winds up staying in, obviously, because we already saw that. He goes for Giga Drain. It's neutral. It does a pretty good amount. Honestly, I probably could have gotten away with going for two Dragon Claws and killing it, but I don't know. I just decided to go for an Earthquake because it's, you know, it's boosted. But Dragon Claw would have been better because he doesn't resist Earthquake. You know, he resisted Earthquake. So he would not have resisted Dragon Claw. It would have done more. So in hindsight already, it would have been better to not go for Earthquake. He sends in Calidemos, and at this point I'm like, eh, that's fine. Sticky Webs is going to slow it down. And if it decides to go for any reason, if it decides to go for, Iron Head because I was hoping for a flinch. Yeah, that's right. But he made that switch. I'm obviously going to stay in because Earthquake, I have that chance to take it out. It's super effective. And if it goes for Baneful Bunker, Earthquake is not making physical contact, so I won't get poisoned. And it almost one-shots, but not quite able to make that. He goes for Ice Beam, which I totally forgot that Toxapex can learn Ice Beam. And so he takes out my Darude that way. Darude was honestly pretty important and kind of threw him away. And if I would have gone for Dragon Claw, it would have done way more than Iron Head, obviously, because Iron Head's resisted. So I decide here to go ahead and go into, I think, Magnezone at this point to go back in. So I go back into Babe Magnet, my Magnezone. And I decided to go for a Thunderbolt, I believe. Or maybe it was a Volt Switch trying to make a read here. I just went for Thunderbolt right now. And I think Devin was like, if I switch this thing out, it's going to die already. No, that's right. He went for Baneful Bunker to try to get some recovery back. So, honestly, not really a bad plan on his part, but he should have just kind of let it go down or should have just made the switch. He should have just made the switch and back into Shikaku because Shikaku was still alive at this point. He could have gotten the immunity and made me switch again. He would have forced me to switch once more, but he didn't make that connection there. Sometimes it happens. I mean, obviously, you guys have been seeing me already flubbing quite a bit here, but it happens to the best of us. And, I mean, unfortunately, obviously, it's not going to really match my lips right here. It ain't going to match my lips, which is annoying, but it always it happened today. He's going to take the spikes damage. This is when he makes a switch into Shikaku, and this is where I went for Thunderbolt, thinking that he was just going to go ahead and stay in, but he didn't. He made the switch. So because of that, now obviously I have to switch. I can't stay in. There's no way. So I decide, you know what? I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to make that switch right now. I ain't going to stay in here and let this thing smack me, you know, forwards and backwards. So I switch out. I go into Shikaku, my own Shikaku, which, to be honest, I should have just gone into Bulu, but I didn't make that connection. So he goes for Earth Power, and it does a solid amount. This is what makes me think that it actually is probably Specs. But I go ahead, and I stay in, and at this point, I'm thinking he's going to switch into Decidueye. So I decide to make this read, which I'm so glad I did, and I go for Shadow Ball with my choice Specs, and he switches in, gets a Sticky Web so he slows down, and then he also has the spikes damage, which I think is what really caused it to do so much damage. But as we get the Shadow Ball, as it goes off, we see right here that it was a crit, which is nuts. So we got that crit, but it might have mattered, to be honest. I think it mattered. I really do. But it might not have. I mean, Decidueye is pretty bulky, but Choice Specs Max Special Attack is a lot of damage. We get that crit, though. Oh, my. All right, we still see the spikes. Trace's Water Compaction. All right, well, don't really have a choice but to switch in Bulu right now. He is unfortunately going to know that I'm Specs. He might not, though. You might not. Ice beam. Whoa. Should have known. That is doing so much damage. That is doing so much damage. Well, this thing does not have download. So, not too worried about it. Not too worried about it. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go for... Will superpower kill, though? I don't know if superpower would kill. This thing is obviously evil. Eviolite. I'm gonna hit it with that leech seed. Withdrew! Yes! Yes! He's gonna withdraw. There's gonna be no stat lowering because of. Of course. Of course we miss. Of course we miss. Of course we had to miss. Alright, this thing. Wait. But Simblin Sakura doesn't have Earthquake unless he put Earthquake on it. I'm probably making... he's just going to go for a Steel-type move right now. Yeah, he's going to Mega Evolve and go for a Steel-type move. But he probably put Earthquake on this thing. Meteor Mash. Okay, so Steel-type move. We take it. We take it incredibly well. But I doubt we're going to take an Earthquake. So, that being said, Simblin Sakura would not do good. Wait, no, he's not going to go for Earthquake because of the grassy terrain. We'll live. So I'm going to go for Hidden Power Fire. Even if he has Earthquake, I'll live because of the grassy terrain. Because it's weakened. And even if he switches into Calidemos, it's going to take some damage. Zen Headbutt. Don't get that flinch. Don't you do it. Yes, but he did get a crit, which sucks. Oh, that's like a 3-hit KO. 4-hit KO because of grassy terrain. Wow. That crit really stung. Probably going to see another Zen Headbutt here. But we got a crit too, so... Oh, that wasn't a crit. I was like, did he get another crit? Was that a crit? No, wasn't a crit. It just did a lot. Okay. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to live another one of those. Grassy terrain is gone, so Earthquake is back on the table. At this point, I kind of feel like switching in Chukaku, but Chukaku's not that bulky, so... Darn it. I'm going to switch in my own Senbon Sakura. See the rock slide. Trying to go for the flinches, probably. Rock Slide would do more. Because it's not resisted. Or no, it is resisted. Because he's still type. Whatever. Let's see who wins a speed tie. Come on. Nope, he won the speed tie. Goes for Meteor Mash. That's so much. No! No! We miss? Okay, please, can we win the speed tie? Please, can we win the speed tie? He wins a speed tie again? Okay, good. No! What is going on? Well, I think we're dead. Please, can we crit? Can we get an attack raise? Can we get an attack raise? We get a crit. Oh, thank you. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. These crits. And the misses, like, all the hacks are crazy right now. Alright, Magic Conch coming in here. I'm already terrified of this thing. I've been terrified since day one. At least we're gonna get the sticky webs slow down here. Apparently Rock Slide's effective. Hopefully I can get this thing to flinch. But at least it's not Mega. Flinch. Flamethrower. Yeah, I wasn't going to switch this thing out anyway to save it for later. For a rainy day. I wasn't going to save it for a rainy day. Okay, so I'm going to switch in Shukaku. And I'm going to go for a Giga Drain. A boosted Choice Specs Giga Drain should be enough to completely one-shot. Yep. See you later, Magic Conch. He's going to go for a Scald. And we're probably going to be dead. We live! He gets a crit and a burn! What are these hacks? Oh my gosh. What are these hacks? What are these flipping hacks, man? I don't understand. Okay, taking out Magic Conch is awesome because of that flamethrower pressure. Oh, on Bulu. What else does he have? Gosh darn it, Shukaku. What else does he have? Kelly Demos. That is awesome. Okay. Good. Kelly Demos is slowing down, but it's probably just going to go for a Baneful Bunker until we die. From our burn, which sucks. He didn't go for Baneful Bunker. So we're going to kill it and probably, yeah, we're going to live our burn now. We're going to live our burn now. Oh my gosh, we live our burn. We take care of Kalidemos, which is huge because of Bulu with that poison jab pressure. We would have killed it anyway though, because we would have outsped and we would have been able to get a Horn Leech off, but it could have gone for Baneful Bunker and poisoned us. Which a poison Bulu is not a fun Bulu. Okay. It's going to get caught in Sticky Web. It's going to be slow. And it's also getting hit by that. So the Giga Drain could do something for us. It does have Water Compaction, which doesn't matter. I'd rather have that than like Grassy Terrain or something stupid. Ice Beam, so it still outspeeds us. Even after the Sticky Webs. So we're dead. Okay. I really got to think this through. Really got to think this through. To be honest, I think my best option is just to go into Bait Magnet, fire off a Thunderbolt. Straight up, just fire off a Thunderbolt right now, and hope that I do enough damage with a max Thunderbolt, max special attack. Hopefully, I outspeed. We do outspeed. Yes. Can we get a crit? Can we get a para? Can we get a paralyze? We don't get a paralyze. He goes for Trick Room. He's making himself faster, but he's also making me faster in the late game with Bulu. So hopefully I can live an Ice Beam or something, or a Tri-Attack. Hopefully I can live this Tri-Attack with my Assault Vest. Oh my gosh, we live. Oh, that did like nothing. That did like nothing! Oh my gosh, this is so huge, man. Assault Vest, Sassy Nature. Oh, that's right, but he does have Recover. Okay, hopefully we can get the Para. It would make him faster, though, but hopefully he'll, you know, we'll start getting some para hacks. Ooh, was that a... We get a crit! If we get another crit, he's dead. We get another crit. He is dead. He goes for another recover. I can always go for a Volt Switch, go into Bulu when he's going to recover, and get a... before he recovers. And get a... superpower off. Ice Beam, which... granted, it's going to do more, but... not much more. Hopefully we get the para. Come on, get the para. Okay, dimensions are twisted back to normal. Thunderbolt, I feel like... would Flash Cannon do more? I don't know if Flash Cannon would do more or less. I'm going to try Flash Cannon, see if it does more. Because we could get the Special Defense drop. Flash Cannon looked like it did more. And he's going for a recover. Alright. I'm going to go for a Flash Cannon because Special Defense drop is more important, I feel. Come on, Special Defense drop. Come on. Come on. He's just going to go for another recover. I can stall. I mean, we can do the stall war, man. We can do the stall war. But I'd rather not. Might be a dumb idea, but I'm going to switch in Bulu. I'm going to get a Leech Seed off, and then I'll probably switch. Grassy Terrain is not a good idea, but it also is a good idea because I have Superpower. Oh, he went for Tri-Attack. Yeah, this match is over. He got the burn. He got the burn hacks, man. Of all the things for him to get, he gets burn hacks. So many hacks! He burned us with what else did he burn us with? I can't even remember now. Oh yeah, he got a crit scald burn. He got a crit scald burn earlier. Alright. I'm hoping that Leech Seed goes off. Yes, it doesn't miss! He goes for Ice Beam. We're living it. Barely, but we're living it. And at this point, I'm going to go for a Horn Leech. I'm going to get my HP back, man. He can burn me, but I'm going to go for a Horn Leech. I'm going to get my HP back. Because I'm already losing so much HP right now. Granted, Horn Leech won't do much, but it'll hopefully, with this Grassy Terrain boost... oh no, that's giving me nothing. Yeah, it's giving me nothing. Yeah, he's gonna keep going for Ice Beam. That burn really just put it over the edge, man. That's the thing. Even with leftovers, Grassy Terrain HP, and Leech Seed recovery, it's not enough. Which stinks. Alright, so I think I know what I'm going to do here. I'm going to switch back into Babe Magnet. I'm expecting a recover here. Nope, there's the Ice Beam. If we can live it, we live it. And that was 12, so we can live another Ice Beam. And we're going to get Leech Seed recovery right now. Yep. There's the Leech Seed recovery. Perfect. Which, we're at 12 right now. It gets us up to 36! Yeah, we're good. So all I have to do now is just hit him with a few Thunderbolts. He goes for recover right now, probably. It won't matter, because we will get our recovery. We get the para! Yes! Okay, he goes for recover. Doesn't matter. I'm going to get my Grassy Terrain recovery. I'm also going to get the leech seed recovery and get Babe Magnet up on the HP here. And I'll just keep siphoning the HP from Duck. I'll just keep getting this beautiful, beautiful HP. Mmm. The tastiness, the tastiness. It's so good. It's so tasty. I love it. I love it. Grassy terrain is gone, but I'm still going to get leech seed recovery. And I'm going to just go over another Thunderbolt. You go for Tri-Attack, does nothing to me. Yes. And we get the Leech Seed recovery. And hopefully we can one-shot with a Thunderbolt now. Hopefully I can one-shot with a Thunderbolt. I'm in the green, man. I'm in the flipping green. Let's one-shot right now. Let's one-shot with this Thunderbolt. Can we one-shot? Can we one-shot? We can't one-shot. He goes for a cover. But I'm going to get more HP. Ugh. This is fine, man. This is fine. Because we're stalling him out. He's just gonna have to resort to doing Trick Room or something, if anything. And we're just getting our HP up, man. I'm almost up to full HP. I am almost up to full HP right now. If we get a crit, though, he's dead. Goes for another recover. I'm gonna be at max HP. Once it gets to max HP, I'll probably go for a Volt Switch. In fact, I think I'll go for a Volt Switch right now. Oh, he withdraws. And he goes into Shukaku. Yikes. Shukaku's caught in the sticky web. He gets hit by spikes. Volt Switch obviously doesn't do anything. We should be able to outspeed Shukaku, but I don't care. I'm switching in Bulu. I'm going to weaken the power of Earth Power, and I'm going to also be able to get a Horn Leech off and kill Shukaku. There's the Earth Power. Yep. We take it like a champ. We get some HP back. He's going to get some HP back, which is even better for us because we can steal that HP once I go for Horn Leech. And, of course, we have our Leftovers recovery. So this is what I'm going to go for Horn Leech right now. That way, even if he switches back in, Porygon's going to take that damage plus the spikes. So I'm going to be doing Horn Leech plus spikes. Come on, baby. Come on. Come on, baby. Come on. Withdraw Shukaku. That's fine. Goes back into Duck. That's cool. Sticky webs. And paralyzed. And spikes. Traces grassy surge, which doesn't matter. Horn Leech is a thing. Show me that HP, that gooda gooda. And now, even at this point, I think I'm actually at enough to where... I'm at the point now where I'll live in Ice Beam. And Superpower, even with my burn, should kill. So I'll live in Ice Beam. Superpower should kill. We'll see if it does. I'm hoping it will. It doesn't. It doesn't kill. That sucks. We're going to live the Ice Beam, though. Yep, we live the Ice Beam. Man, this is unfortunate. This is a total stall war. But now, of course, I have no choice but to go back and switch in Babe Magnet. Try to get him to make that switch again into Shukaku. And when he makes a switch, I'll go for a Flash Cannon. And Shukaku will die. He gets fully paralyzed. Let's go. Let's go. At this HP, he's barely in the yellow. He's probably still actually going to live a Thunderbolt, but we'll see. He's probably going to make the switch right now. Nope, he doesn't make the switch. He stays in. Can we kill Duck? We can kill Duck! We kill Duck! Holy cow, and we're back to max HP. A grassy terrain's gone. Okay. We're back to max HP, baby. Holy cow, this match. Here comes in Shikaku. Shikaku's going to take spikes. It's going to be slowed down by sticky webs. Okay. I am a Salt Vest, so I can... You know what? I can live in Earth Power. And I don't even need to, because I outspeed. Flash Cannon goes off. Max Special Attack. Let's go! Shikaku's down. Shikaku's down. We get the match. GG. Thank you, Devin. Amazing, man. Amazing match. Two great Wi-Fi battles. Absolutely incredible. Guys, here we go. Dragon Army, we are getting ourselves a battle right here with Orion, a rematch. She is an incredible battler. And last time she creamed us. Let's see how we do this time. She brought Celesteela, which I did not know was OU at the time. And kind of got broadsided. So hopefully, we'll see what happens this time. Hopefully we can actually get ourselves a win. But we shall see. I switched up my team a little bit here. And I think it's a good one, but we'll see what happens. Alright, so I'm going to show you guys my team right now. I am running with something a little bit different. I decided to put H2O Dankness on my team and Orihime the Chansey. And I decided to switch out Senbu and Sakura the Metagross for Slowbro, because Slowbro just, it gives us more options. And I think I'm going to go ahead and go with the Battle Royale theme. Kind of feeling that right now. So I'm going to go with the Battle Royale theme. And here we go. Yeah. Here we go. I'm pretty hyped. I'm pretty hyped. So we'll see what happens here. Honestly, I'm feeling pretty good about this. Feeling pretty good about this. Because I have my spinner. I don't really need to worry about hazards with this team. Because I don't really have like any fire types or flying types. So I don't have to really worry about spikes or anything like that. Okay, so we see the Pimimikyu. Which Pimimikyu is a problem if we don't have a taunt user and or knockoff user, but I'm not too worried about it. We are going to see the Cloyster, which is really scary. So I think what I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to lead with, I'm kind of thinking about leading with Babe Magnet, and then I'm going to go ahead and go from there, because I can get a Volt Switch off if I need to. If she has a Stealth Rock setter, the only thing it could be is the Pimimikyu, but I don't even know if it has access to Stealth Rocks. I don't even know. We could see spikes from Cloyster. It might be a spike setter, but we'll see what happens here. If she leaves a Cloyster, that would be the best option, because then I can go ahead and just go for a Flash Cannon and then switch out. So I'm going to leave a Bay Magnet. Let's see what she leads with. She's going to leave with Marowak. Okay, so this is different. This is different because I was not expecting a Marowak lead. So because of this Marowak lead, I think I'm going to go ahead and I just got to think about this for a second here. I'm expecting that she's going to go for a Bone Meringue. But it's too risky to switch in to Hapabulu if she does go for Flare Blitz. So I'm just trying to think. If I do switch in Orihime, I can always Toxic this thing and start to whittle it down, which would be very nice. Magic Conch would suffer from Shadow Bone, but doesn't care about Bone Meringue, and also does not care at all about what's it called? Doesn't really care at all about Flare Blitz. So I'm just trying to think. This actually is problematic. I could go into Marowak and probably Marowak. I could go into Kingdra, my H2O Dankness, and probably kill it with a Scald. I could honestly probably kill it with a Scald, but it's kind of risky. So, then I could also kill it with a Scald on with Magic Conch. So you know what? I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna switch into H2O Dankness, and I'm gonna go for a Scald. I am Specs. I should be able to one shot. Even if this thing is bulky. Shadow Bone. Alright. So. Oh, dang. Yeah, I'm going to go for Scald. Because we should be able to one-shot. I'm confident. And Marowak's not that fast either. So we should be able to outspeed as well. I'm hoping we outspeed. Otherwise, this was a total waste. And I'm going to be kind of sad. But, I mean, Orion's a great battler. So it's like I can't really expect, you know what I mean? I'm not gonna underestimate. Not at all. You know, I gotta really be on my toes. So we're gonna see the switch into Gyarados. So if we do burn this, that would be super, super solid. If we were able to burn this thing right now. So hopefully we can burn it right now. And we'll see what happens here. Can we burn? Please? No, we don't get the burn. We don't get the burn, which means, unfortunately, I have to switch right now. But the good thing about this is that I can go ahead and switch in Magic Conch right now. Because Gyarados can't really do anything to Magic Conch. That's the fun part! Gyarados can go for Dragon Dance, but I can just Scald this thing. I can Mega Evolve Scald and try to get a burn. Once I get that burn, I don't have to worry about Gyarados. So I'm gonna go ahead, Mega Evolve, go for the Scald, and should be able to get the burn. This thing can't crit me either, obviously, so I don't have to worry about that. So let's see what happens. Pimimikyu could be coming in right now. Here's the Waterfall, which we resist. We take it incredibly well. No flinch, which is awesome. We get the Scald. Hopefully we can get the burn. Come on. Yes, we get the burn. Okay, awesome. Oh, okay, Lumberry. Very nice. So we see the Lumberry, which is unfortunate for us, but now I know that I can go ahead and freely fire off another Scald. Obviously, Waterfall isn't too much pressure for us. I could have gone for a Calm Mind, but we'll see where this goes. We're going to see the Withdraw into Tapu Lele. Burning Tapu Lele would also be really nice. But Tapu Lele is very strong. And hers is, I believe, Specs. Oh, no. Okay, hers is raising her special defense in... Okay, that sucks. Can we get the burn? We don't get the burn. Okay, raising the special defense, which is unfortunate. And it's kind of going to force me to switch here. Because I think a Shadow Ball is on its way. I really do. But if a Shadow Ball is on its way, I mean, Babe Magnet can kind of just come in and dance on the face of this Lele because I'm a Assault Vest Max Special Defense. So I'm not too worried. But I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to be that guy. And I'm going to predict. I'm actually going to predict the Shadow Ball because ultimately, Orihime Chansey is just so much better at taking this. And I can go ahead and fire off a Toxic. We're going to see Moonblast, which we are going to take. We're going to take it very well. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go for the Toxic right now. Because taking out Lele is pretty big. Taking out Lele is kind of huge. If we can take out Lele, this thing is strong and it does a lot to our team. But either way, if we get the Toxic off, it's a win-win, you know? It's a win-win. As long as I can Toxic something, I'm a happy man. So we'll see what happens here. See, look at this. She is thinking. She's like, I got a timer. I'm going to use it. And I don't blame her. So far I know she has Gyarados. She has Tapu Lele. She has Marowak. Those are the three mons I know. She also has Pimimikyu. And I cannot remember who else. So I know four mons right now. I cannot remember the rest at the moment. I cannot remember the rest. She's gonna withdraw. Okay. Special defense is gone. Marowak comes out, and we get to toxic Marowak. So this is awesome. This is so awesome right now. Yes, we don't miss. It connects. This is super, super, super key. So we toxic Marowak, which is awesome. Now Marowak is gonna have to take that damage. And now I kind of get to freely just switch out right now. It's kind of what I get to do. And I think I'm gonna go ahead and just... I mean, it sucks, but I think I'm gonna sack off H2O Dankness because I don't really know how else H2O Dankness is gonna be able to fit in right now with this team. Like, I don't know what it's really gonna be able to do. And I don't really have anything else that wants to go against Marowak right now. I kind of just need to play this stall war here until this Marowak dies, because this Marowak kind of walls my entire team, to be perfectly honest. It kind of walls my entire team, just with how strong it is. Flare Blitz, yep. It's going to force Marowak to get some damage onto itself. H2O Dankness is kind of switch fodder, it really was. And a little bit of recoil damage and the toxic damage is always nice. It's always nice. And now I'm kind of thinking about... Yeah, I think Magic Conch is the answer right now. Switch your Magic Conch. Get that Scald off. I ain't gotta worry about it. Go for that Scald. Shadow Bone. I'm going to be able to take it pretty well. Not amazingly well, but well enough. And we should be able to kill. After the poison, we should be able to kill it. Nope, we don't even need the poison. Awesome. We got rid of Marowak, which is literally so huge right now. So huge. Getting rid of Marowak was big time. Because now I don't have to worry about that fire pressure on to my Bulu. I don't have to worry about the Flare Blitz. Like, incredible strength. Ninetales is coming in. Sup, Ninetales. Snow Warning is annoying, but it's not really the end of the world. To be honest, this thing can't really do anything to me. I'm going to go for a Slack Off. It might be able to kill me with a Blizzard. Nope, it goes for a Moonblast, which I think I should be able to live one. I should be able to live one of them. I can't even live one? I thought I could live at least one Moonblast. And it's Life Orb. Okay, so now that I see that it's Life Orb... This is really interesting, man. This is super interesting. I mean, a Moonblast isn't going to be able to do anything to Babe Magnet. It really isn't. And I'm just going to be able to fire off a free Flash Cannon. But I kind of feel like making reads today. So just in case, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fire off a Thunderbolt because I kind of feel like we're going to see a switch here. I could be wrong, but I feel like we're going to see a switch here. I think Gyarados is coming in, and it's going to try to take that Flash Cannon. Or Pamimikyu is going to come in and try to take the Flash Cannon. Well, actually, no, that would be super effective against Pamimikyu. Darn it, Flash Cannon would be the best option. I think I done messed up. I messed up. Yep. Blizzard, I'm going to be able to take very well. Because I am Assault Vest. But I should have gone for the Flash Cannon. We get the Para. Okay, that's really, really awesome. That's awesome. So, I think it's still going to outspeed me, though. But I'm going to go for Flash Cannon anyway. We get the full Para! Oh my gosh! Dude! Yeah! Let's do this thing, man! Let's do this thing! Okay, so Ninetales is gone. This is awesome. I don't have to worry about Ninetales pressure on Bulu either now with the crazy ice or the hail. And hail's going to go away in, like, probably, I think, 2 turns because it's already been about 3 turns of hail. I'm feeling good right now. I'm feeling good. All right, Cloyster's coming in here. I don't like Cloyster at all, but I should be able to kill Cloyster with a Thunderbolt. Cloyster's going for Shell Smash. Even after it's white herb, I think we should be able to one shot because we are max. We are max special attack. So we should be able to kill it. I don't see a white herb. Yeah, so we're gonna build it. Oh, it's focus sash. Oh, snap. Focus sash? I was not expecting that. Well, shiver me timbers. I think we might be dead here. Hidden power fire? But we live! Oh my gosh, the assault vest is real! The assault vest is flipping real right now, man! Babe Magnet coming through! Babe Magnet sweep! No more hail! Goodbye, hail! No more sweep! Oh my gosh, I need a drink of water! Oh my gosh! In comes in the Gyarados. I already know this Gyarados has Earthquake. You're not fooling me, Gyarados. I already know you have Earthquake. I don't even know, like, what's happening right now, man. This is just nuts. I already know this thing has Earthquake, though. I mean, it's gotta have Earthquake. No, it's gonna go for Waterfall? That wouldn't have done much. I mean, I resist this, too. It would not have done much. But I have to keep, 100% have to keep, Babe Magnet around. Because Babe Magnet is, like, pretty much the ultimate for, Lele. Okay, so I gotta really think about this. I'm gonna go for, as dumb as this might seem, I'm gonna go for Leech Seed, actually, right now. There's the Ice Fang. Okay. That was kind of a dumb move on my part. Please thaw, please thaw, please thaw, please thaw. Oh. That's unfortunate. So, seeing that they, you know, Gyarados went for Waterfall and did not go for... Man, I don't know. I mean, we already did one turn of freezing, so we should be able to thaw out. And I'm going to go for a Horn Leech. I feel like I should switch, but... Oh, okay. No, I'm glad I didn't switch. Because we're going to see the Dragon Dance. So if I can kill this thing, it'd be huge. Please thaw. Please thaw, buddy. Come on. Please thaw, buddy. Come on. Come on, buddy. Why aren't you thawing out? Why aren't you thawing out? Well, I think I'm dead for sure now. Unfortunately. Yeah, I kind of think we're kind of dead for sure now. I'm going to go for another Horn Leech though. Ice Fang, hopefully we live. By some stretch of the imagination, we do live. I am literally, that's, wow, 3 freezes in a row. That sucks. Yeah, that really sucks. Man. Well, the Earthquake might have been hidden this entire time, but either way. I'm gonna go for a Sludge Wave because of damage. Not because of a burn, because a burn is risky at this at best. Waterfall is going to connect. We do resist, but Dragon Dance is a thing. No flinch, thank God. We get the Sludge Wave. Hopefully we can get a snag of poison and kill it with a poison. Can we get a poison? We can't get a poison. Wow. This match has just been... has been very interesting, to say the least. Going to withdraw Gyarados going into Pimimikyu? Yep. Pimimikyu, I think, is water and poison? Or is it water and rock? I cannot remember. It's leftovers. Okay. Wait a minute. It's just water type. What does Pamimikyu want to do besides stall me out? What can it do? It can't burn me. Oh no, it could burn me with a skull, but it can't toxic me. So then what's the point of having it in? Switching in babe ma- Oh, that's right. This thing is a screen setter. I forgot. This thing is a screen setter. Switching in babe magnet is probably my best bet, actually, right now. Because I might toxic this thing, but there's no guarantees. And if I switch in babe magnet, I can just go for a thunderbolt. Soak. This is what... This I'm okay with. This I'm okay with, transforming me into water type. I'm okay with this. Now I'm going to go for a thunderbolt. And we're gonna be able to kill this thing next. Oh, that's right, we're water type now, so we can be toxic, but doesn't really matter because I can kill this thing right now, take one turn of toxic, and then after I take the turn of toxic, I can switch in Orihime, go for aromatherapy and get rid of my toxic. Which I'm actually gonna volt switch out. Goes into Tapu Lele, which is fine. Psychic Surge gets set up. Totally cool with that. I'm going to go for a Volt Switch. And I'm going to switch out. Now I'm going to switch in... I think this... No, yeah, this... Tapu Lele has Thunderbolt. Tapu Lele has Thunderbolt. And it probably has Focus Blast as well. I'm actually going to go for a Seismic Toss. I was going to go for Aromatherapy, but I'm going to go for a Seismic Toss. Because I need to kill Lele. Taking out Lele is like priority number one right now. I could Toxic it, but... I need to try to get some solid damage on this thing. And I can kill it with two Seismic Tosses, I'm pretty sure. I should be able to take it out with two Seismic Tosses. So we'll see what happens. This is a great match. Absolutely amazing match. I love it. So I gotta think. Psychic and Fairy. Don't have to worry about Soak anymore. It's gone. And if she brings in the Pamimikyu, which is what I'm hoping will happen. Nope. Psychic. Which I'm gonna be able to take. Yep. Even if it is Specs. And, yep, we're going to be able to kill it with another Seismic Toss. So this Seismic Toss will kill it. I'm going to live the Psychic and be able to kill this thing. Yep, goes for another Psychic. It's obviously Specs. Seismic Toss. Tapu Lele's dead. This is awesome. Beautiful. Tapu Lele's gone. This is awesome. Gyarados is going to come in. Now, Gyarados getting me down to this level is... probably low enough to where it can kill me. But I don't know. So I'm going to try to go for a Seismic Toss and take out Gyarados. Goes for Waterfall. Hopefully we can live. We live, but we flinch. Of course, we flinch. I could actually let Orihime go down right now. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and let Orihime go down because yeah, Orihime can't really do anything else right now. So here we go. Down. Weirdiness is gone, whatever. Who cares? Now is when I'm going to go ahead and switch in Can't Touch Me. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fire off a sludge wave. And really hope that I don't get flinched again. Waterfall. Come on. That's not what I want to see. Come on. Come on, I gotta break through. If I can break through, I have a chance. Come on. Yes. Sludge Wave connects. Gyarados is down. Awesome. Okay, cool. Cool. In comes in Pimimikyu. Pimimikyu can turn me into water type. I don't care. I'm going to go for a sludge wave. Come on, let's get that poison. Come on. I've had so many hacks done to me. Can we get poison? We can't get poison. We do see recover, though. Man. Pimimikyu is a problem. I can't poison this thing. I don't know. That's kind of my best bet. Can it go for soak? Okay. Transform me into water type. Obviously, it's not going to do as much. Now I'm hurt by black sludge, which is unfortunate. Wow, that is such a good strat. I think a recover is gonna happen right now, so I'm gonna switch. Yep, there's a recover. I have about 2 turns. Because this thing has no attacking moves. And it can't toxic me now. So, obviously, because I'm already toxic. What am I saying? That moment when your logic is wrong. Goes for soak. Okay. I already know we outspeed it. And we should be able to kill it with a thunderbolt. We should be able to kill it with a thunderbolt. Come on. Yes! Woo-hoo-hoo! Don't ever tell me the odds. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Beautiful battle. GG. I am so hyped on that win. Oh my goodness gracious. GG to Orion. Oh, thank you. Dragon Army, we got us a win. This is Jog the Dragon, and I am flying off.